Hi friends, some time ago a video was published where I showed the construction of an induction soldering iron. Today we will continue and will consider the whole station circuit. Why the second part published so late? The fact is that I wanted to find the best option for the generator. I tried many variants, starting from the microcircuits of the UC family and ending with a rather stiff PWM controller CG3525. Almost all the options worked quite well, but they had one drawback. The circuits need to be adjusted to any particular inductor. This makes tuning difficult for beginners. In the end, I came to a simple version. It's a well-known two-stroke auto-generator. I know that some will start criticizing, but this variant is genius simple, doesn't require any adjustment, and has a low-cost price. Let's come closer to the point. The station consists of three parts. Power supply, pulse step-down regulator with the possibility of output adjustment, and the generator itself on two powerful field effect transistors. The printed circuit board is the only one. All three parts of the station are located on it. You can download PCB with a full archive of project. The link is in the description. The power unit is a rather popular auto-generating half-bridge inverter. This circuit is a typical electronic transformer for office 12-volt halogen lamps supplemented by a rectifier. The rectifier is push-pull with an average point. Power supply ability is about 80 watts, but it would be enough 50. The power supply may be different. It is important that it provide a constant voltage of 18 to 20 volts at a current of 2-3 amperes. We will not stop on this part. If anyone is interested in the details related to a similar power supply, there is a description in the link to the detailed video. Next is the impulse stabilizer. I decided to put a ready module based on the stabilizer XL4D15. The stabilizer module will allow you to change the supply voltage of the generator. This way we change the power and hence the temperature of the tip. Naturally, for such purposes, it would be simpler to select another kind of generator with PWM control, which would allow smoothly changing the power through regulating of the duty cycle of the pulses on the gate of the field transistors. But I repeat that the circuit with the PWM needed some tuning. The stabilizer board is designed for a current of 5 amperes. Actually, it doesn't give out so much, at least for a long time, but in our case it requires a maximum of 2 amperes, so the stabilizer doesn't heat up during operation. The circuit of the generator is built on the basis of two field effect transistors IRFZ44. You can use others with a current of 20 amperes. I don't advise less. Transistors are loaded with a pulse transformer, the secondary winding of which is an incomplete turn of a thick copper wire. The ends of the thick wire are connected to the inductor. Using a separating transformer made it possible to reduce the diameter of the inductor wire. If anyone remembers the first option, the inductor wire was much thicker. Now the diameter is only 0.6 mm. The converter operates on the principle of push-pull type circuits. The primary winding of the transformer together with the capacitor form a parallel oscillatory circuit. The main operating frequency of the circuit depends on the resonant frequency of the oscillatory circuit. The second advantage of using a separating transformer is that the parameters of the inductor do not affect the operation of the circuit as a whole, since unlike the original circuit, in our version the inductor is not involved in the LC circuit. The design of the tip has also changed. In the course of experiments, I noticed that a tip from the most common soldering station contains iron or iron alloys in its composition, and the inductor perfectly heats such a monolithic tip. Before winding the inductor, the tip was insulated with a heat-resistant tape. The same insulation is on the top of the circuit. The number of the turns in my case is 12. It sounds strange, but during the work on the board almost nothing heats up, since they are literally all with the multiple reserves. But I advise anyway to install transistors of the power supply and the generator on small radiators. If use one common radiator, all transistors should be isolated from it. Before starting tests, specifically for skeptics, I will show that it really works on the principle of induction heating. The The maximum power for the soldering iron is 25 watts, but the tip easily warms up to a temperature of 440 to 450 Celsius degrees. Although it takes about 30 seconds, but it is very good for such a small device. The soldering iron works well. It is enough for most cases. Despite the modest maximum power of only 25 watts, it does well with massive areas. Although, if you want, you can raise the power by increasing the supply voltage and overall power of the transformer. In the future, this design will be placed in the box. Device is simple, nothing special, but the reliability is at the level. Besides, the cost of assembling is very low. Almost all components, apart from the FETs, are taken out from the old boards. Friends, I remind that the archive of the project can be downloaded from the link in the description. There will also be links to the purchase of the budget induction soldering stations. If you find this video interesting and useful, then please put thumb up and share it with friends in social networks. Have a nice day! With you was Kasian TV.